My name's Brian Ruff, I'm a historian, and we're at Fort Lytton National Park at Brisbane in Queensland. Fort Lytton's one of the more significant heritage sites in Brisbane. It was established in the 1880s, and the aim of it was to protect Brisbane from potential raid or invasion, I guess, from the 1880s right through to World War II.
The SLAM technology is a method of taking an existing device called a laser scanner, moving it around the environment, and actually coming up with a full three-dimensional map of that environment.
We're using the Zebedee scanner here at Fort Lytton today to capture a 3D point cloud model of the site.
This is something that we've never been able to achieve before. To get someone in to even draw up the existing fortifications would be months and months of work.
It's allowed us to capture a huge range of sites that we wouldn't normally be able to capture, and it's really helped our work in cultural heritage, ranging from sites that are really difficult to get to and remote, to sites that are really fragile and in danger of being overtaken by natural disasters. We can produce 3D renderings of buildings really fast. It's almost photographic.
Part of using these tools is just to allow us to measure change over time. And if we're to preserve these buildings, you know, not just for next year, but for the next 50 years or the next 100 years, we have to be able to understand what's happening to the site.
It's a huge archive of 3D points, so you can go through and cut sections, you can cut plans, you can take the roof off and see what it's like inside. So you can see what the surfaces look like, you can see the cracks in the walls, you can see where the holes in the floors are.
Many cultural heritage sites are hard to get to. They may be on islands, in the middle of forests, difficult terrain. This system is great in that it's very small, it's easy to transport.
We captured a huge site at Peel Island in Moreton Bay. It's an amazing site, but it's got lots and lots of buildings on it. The Zebedee scanner allowed us to capture that whole huge Peel Island site in just 4 hours. What the 3D images really brought home to us was the difference in treatment of Aboriginal people and white people on Peel Island. So in the future, we're hoping that we can use this amazing data to give people an architectural experience of places that they might not normally be able to go, including cultural heritage sites.
What's exciting about this 3D mapping project is that we can overlay historic data over the data that's been collected here today. And that will enable us to view the site over a period of time. And from the point of view of interpreting the site, that's just something that we could never otherwise do.